Deer are successful across North America because they are adaptable animals. As long as the deer's habitat provides forage for health and reproduction and shelter to survive harsh conditions, populations can thrive. Short-term mortality events, including severe winters or outbreaks of hemorrhagic disease, will reduce the population. But future reproduction will allow the population to recover within a couple years. Recovery is quick because of the reproductive potential of adult females. For example, Jane Doe produces two fawns every spring, with at least one typically surviving through its first birthday. Over her lifetime, Jane Doe will add at least 8 fawns into the population, half female and half male. Each female fawn then starts producing her own fawns at 2 years of age, which can increase population numbers within a couple generations of deer. Once a deer becomes infected with CWD, its annual survival probability declines from 82% to 53%. Hypothetically, if Jane becomes infected with CWD, her lifespan would shorten and she might produce only 4 fawns, 50% fewer than if she hadn't been infected. The effects of losing half her fawns will carry through future generations. Adult bucks may be infected at twice the rate of does, so their mortality is even more significant, but doesn't impact future fawn production as much. When the number of deer born equals the number of deer dying, the population is stable. When the number of deer born is greater than the number of deer dying, the population grows. When the number of deer born is smaller than the number of deer dying, the population declines. Because CWD increases the mortality of bucks and does, fawn production may be reduced. The infection rate in CWD endemic areas is highly variable, and at higher infection rates, CWD may result in a measurable population decline in future years. For example, a 30% CWD prevalence might look like this. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more videos on CWD and deer.